If you want, it's Emily Fox. So this video is going to be my second video about short books. So basically, I wanted to give you more recommendations of books under 250 pages. That's what I consider short, although most of these are like 100 something pages. Basically, books you can read in one go if you are attempting to hit your reading goals on Goodreads, for example, if you have a specific number of books you want to read, or if you just like to have something shorter in between other books, bigger ones, to try and just keep up. I find them very motivating. So let's go through them. I'm sorry if I still sound sick, I definitely am. The first two are nonfiction books about survivors of World War II. Both of these will stick with you forever. They are definitely short, but very impactful. The first one is about 120 pages. It is Night. This is one of those books that I had to remind myself as I was reading it that this was actually nonfiction, because it is so truly horrible. And to think that people had to go through this is just horrifying, literally. But yes, if you want to cry or feel just very sad, this is definitely a nervous laugh. I definitely recommend reading that one. It definitely is something that I will keep thinking about forever. I believe there are more books. I feel like I've seen one called Dawn. So I think there might be three. Anyway, definitely recommend this one. Definitely something I enjoyed. Always feels a little weird saying that about these books, but I did definitely recommend it. Another one of them is Men's Search for Meaning by Viktor E. Frankl. This is interesting in the sense that there are two parts to this one. There is a little part that is definitely is experience in the camps. It's exactly 100 pages. And then the second part is another 50 something pages. It's more about his philosophy of how he thinks he was able to get through those horrifying times, slash how he thinks also other people were able to. It's definitely more like heavy, a little bit philosophical type of thing. And it can pretty much be summarized as having a reason as to why you want to survive. It's more important than how to. You'll find a way, basically. And yeah, definitely something interesting, something I would reread. Although, once again, maybe not anytime soon because of the feels. These are the moments where English being my second language is where I struggle to explain, find the proper words and expressions to explain these books, because they're definitely quite heavy and important. But yes, definitely do recommend it. It is short, but very impactful once again. Let's continue with some tears, because it seems to be a pattern with some of these books. I wanted to mention A Monster Calls by Patrick Ness. This is such an amazing book about grief. You're following a young teenage boy that has to learn how to deal with his mom being sick. And this edition is amazing. If you get a physical copy, there are amazing pictures and drawing in it. And it's just really visually pleasing to look at throughout the read. This was, once again, quite difficult to go through, but in a good way. Definitely something, again, that will stick with you. There is a movie, which I don't think I've seen it. I definitely feel like I need to, but I enjoy this so much more than I expected. And I do enjoy Patrick Ness in general. I feel like he writes amazing YA books, but this one is definitely one of my favorites by him, something that I would definitely recommend to most people. The next book I wanted to mention is a classic, because some classics are shorter and quite easy to read. And this is the case with this one. This is The Picture of Dorian Gray by Oscar Wilde. And it has 230 pages, so I believe it might be one of the biggest one in here, but still under 250, so quite short and quick. The writing style is easy to go through. There's just one chapter where there's like just so many descriptions and you can pretty much skip it. With that said, it's such an accessible, interesting classic that I would recommend to most people. I feel like we pretty much all know what the story is about, but a man finds a way to stay young and pretty, and his picture starts becoming more and more evil looking. And I highly recommend this. It was great. Let's go with a few weirder books. I'm realizing it's a category that I need to talk about. The first one is quite famous because it became a movie so quickly. Bird Box by Josh Malerman. Like I said, it became a movie. We kind of all know dystopian world where first contact with aliens, maybe? Essentially, something happens, and whenever people see it, they kill the people, kill themselves, they go crazy, and you follow a main character who is in the future trying to get somewhere. I know I'm sounding vague, but that's literally the only way of describing this. And I enjoyed the book because of, you know, I like these type of settings. I didn't really care for the ending, and I had a few issues with it, but I did watch the movie, and as much as a bunch of people hated the movie, I think the movie is very well done and pretty much better than the book. So just throwing it out there, usually it's the opposite, but I definitely found that the book did corrected a few things that weren't done well, I feel like, in the book. So definitely would recommend that one. But, you know, if you're curious to compare them, it was still worth a read, an interesting premise to me. I really wanted to talk about this one too, because also very short. This is The Ballad of Black Tom by Victor Laval. I kind of want to say it French, Laval. It has 149 pages, so quite short. This is a very interesting, although a little weird, book. It's kind of a fantasy horror type of setting. I love people were saying that it's a little bit like Lovecraft, which I haven't read any of this stuff, but people were saying it's a bit of a tongue-in-cheek thing because Lovecraft was pretty much racist and the author is a man of color, so I'm not sure about that, but, you know, just throwing it out there. The setting is in New York, so I know a lot of people enjoy reading books about New York. And it has magic in it, and that's literally all I'm going to say, because if you are intrigued by, you know, weird little books, you should just get into it pretty blind, because, again, quite short. But I enjoyed it a lot more than I expected. I went into it pretty blind, except knowing that there was magic in it, and it was interesting. So very curious to read more by the author if he has written anything else, because this was actually surprisingly good. You just never know when you go into a book blind, right? Something else that was extremely weird. I'm thinking of Ending Things by Ian Reid, and I'm not even sure how to explain this book. I would also say it's kind of horror-y. A couple goes to meet the parents of one of them, and things just become weirder and weirder, and it's essentially one of the weirdest books I've ever read. But because it is so strange, you just kind of find yourself not wanting to put it down and trying to figure out if you're guessing correctly or not. And some of the stuff I did see coming, some absolutely not, and it has 210 pages, so kind of short. You can definitely read this in a day or two if you are as intrigued as I was. But yeah, I'm gonna leave it at that, because once again, it's something that is probably better if you go into it pretty blind. But if you're in the mood for a very strange book, this might be it for you. I don't feel like I'm selling these well, but you know, it is what it is. I find that a lot of sci-fi can be an extreme or the other. They're either like 1,000 pages or they're short novellas. And one series that I do enjoy is this one. This is the Murderbot Diaries, the first book being All Systems Red by Martha Wells. And you're following Murderbot, who is a robot, sentient robot, I guess. And Murderbot is kind of funny, doesn't really like humans, but kind of has to work with them. And it goes on adventures, essentially. And I really enjoyed the first book, the second one so-so, the third one was good. And then I believe we are now at 5 books, and I believe they're becoming bigger and bigger. But for sure, the first like three are definitely under 250 pages, and they're definitely worth at least trying the first one to see if you enjoy them. Because if you do, you're gonna wanna binge read the whole thing. And I found them quite different. And again, sci-fi and funny don't usually connect in my head, but it's definitely the case with this series, so would recommend. Another sci-fi series I would recommend checking out is Binti. Super unique and different. The magical system-ish is very different. You're following Binti, who is the first of her people to be sent to a school in space. Things happens on her way there, and obviously at this point it's a trilogy. I think it might just be a trilogy, so you wouldn't have to wait to binge read the whole thing. And I'm pretty sure all three books are under 250 pages, so if you want to binge read the whole thing, you can do so very quickly. So yeah, not necessarily an all-time favorite series, but I definitely feel like the concepts were really interesting, which is like, you might notice at this point, sometimes I will like forgive a book if it's not the best for XYZ reason, as long as the concept is interesting enough. So this was definitely the case for me with this one. I definitely think it's worth a read. Very, very unique. Two modern classics I really wanted to mention. The first one being Animal Farm by George Orwell. I feel like most people read this in high school. I didn't, but it's definitely a high school classic, I feel like. And obviously it has 95 pages, so it's definitely a short book. I'm sure that if you try to analyze the whole thing, it could take you a lot more time. But for me, it was a quick read. I did enjoy it, and I would definitely recommend it. I know a lot of people, this is like their favorite book of all time, but I feel like we kind of all know the whole quote, all animals are equal, but some animals are more equal than others. And it was surprisingly more enjoyable than I thought it would be, so definitely would recommend this. I feel like sometimes we think about like high school, you know, must read, and we're like, you know, nobody ends up really liking them, but I don't know, as an adult, I definitely did enjoy this one. Another modern classic that I was a little skeptical going into, because I had seen a movie, really enjoyed it, and I knew they were very different, the movie and the book, so I was a little scared. I'm talking about iRobot by Isaac Asimov. And the book has 245 pages, so I think this might be the longest one in here. And it is super, super different from Movie with Will Smith. This is technically, is it five short stories? Maybe more. It's a few different short stories that have some similar elements as the movie, but at the same time, it's completely different. So if you just want to compare them, if you just like reading classic sci-fi, this is definitely something I would recommend. I also feel like this wasn't necessarily something that I couldn't put down and that it was like, that became an all-time favorite book, but I found that the concepts were really interesting, especially when you think that these are like some of the first, you know, sci-fi books and everything. So interesting for sure. And then last but not least, I wanted to mention Walking to Alderaan by Adrian Tchaikovsky, the same author as Children of Time that I'm always raving about. This novella is about 100 pages and definitely a quick read. Also quite strange. I feel like it's a team in here. I kept all the weird books together. In this one, humans find this thing at the edge of our solar system and they send a team to try and investigate what it is. The astronauts, basically, they try sending, you know, just satellites and they can't pick up anything. So they send people there and things just become weirder and weirder. And you're not sure if the narrator is actually reliable or not. And kind of first contact with some aliens and things are just really, really weird. So if that's something that you are into, definitely worth a shot. You can probably read this once again in a day. So yeah, very, very strange, but I found it intriguing enough that I wanted to recommend it. I hope you enjoyed this video despite my flu. Don't forget to let me know in the comment section if you have read any of the books mentioned, what you thought about them, if you liked them, hate them, if you have more recommendations for short books for us. I will link down below once again part one that I did. I recommend you check that out too. Thumbs up, subscribe, more videos on the screen where I'm not sick. And I will be seeing you in my next video. Bye. I feel so stuffy. I'm so sorry.